Attention, Sergeant on deck!
In recent videos, we frequently mentioned those components of the Grand Army of the Republic that were unrelated to the Clone Army, which predated and outlasted the cloning program. These parts of the Republic military are rarely addressed, which is a bit of an injustice considering how crucial they were at the start of the war. In this video, we're going to try and give them the acknowledgement that they deserve. Contrary to what some might think, the Republic wasn't completely demilitarized before the Clone Wars. The military was simply small and completely decentralized. The brunt of military roles fell to local sector planetary security forces, while the judicial forces filled the role of galaxy-scale peacekeepers. As we all know, however, both the PSFs and the judicials were incapable of fending off the threat of the CIS military, and so the clones entered the picture. But while the Republic's clone troopers played the largest role in the Clone Wars, the other components of the Republic's military still had their own parts to play after being merged into the Grand Army and the Republic Navy after the Battle of Geonosis. Non-clone forces were actually crucial to the Republic at the start of the Clone Wars. Due to the familiarity of some PSFs with warzone sectors, the command experience of the members of the judicial forces, and due, first and foremost, to their capability to make up for the lack of sufficient numbers of clones. At any given moment during the Clone Wars, there were over 100 battlefronts active at once, in large part due to the patchwork nature of the Confederacy's territory and due to frequent local insurrections. A lot of these battlefronts were held in a state of stalemate through the efforts of non-clone forces, at least until the bulk of the Grand Army was sent in to secure victories. The most crucial non-clone element of the Republic military were the planetary security forces. The PSFs actually predated the Rusan reformations, which formally dissolved the Republic military, but it was only after the reformations that they truly began to come into their own. Through the reformations, a PSF was officially created for each sector of the Republic, to be maintained and run as the governments of their sectors saw fit. At first, this actually worked out quite well, since due to the dissolution of the Republic military, most PSFs were supplied with healthy caches of Sith War veterans and former Republic Navy warships. However, as the Republic expanded into the Outer Rim, the quality of the PSFs began to vary drastically, as new technologies were developed in the core that did not make it out to the Rim. Though a degree of stability was restored with the creation of the College of Planetary Security Forces, a sort of centralized oversight body, the inequalities were nonetheless considerable. Wealthy sector fleets, like those of Rendili, Kuat, Corellia, and other rich worlds, were equipped with state-of-the-art warships and well-trained soldiers, while many Outer Rim PSFs were chronically understaffed and left with small fleets of old warships. Most PSFs, fortunately for the Republic, fell in the middle, and so a degree of peace was kept for nearly a thousand years thanks to the planetary security forces. Some PSFs even intervened to help those in other sectors, especially the more prestigious ones that were based on worlds with strong warrior cultures. When the Clone Wars broke out, the PSFs were sharply divided, as many joined the CIS military, while others sided with the Republic. In some cases, some PSFs were divided, and there were battles fought between soldiers of the same military fighting with the same gear and hastily repainted warships. But despite this, the PSFs actually served as a sort of foundation for the Grand Army of the Republic early in the Clone Wars. Their knowledge of sectors allowed them to hold the line against the Confederacy, and the PSFs maintained most fronts during the Clone Wars, something that isn't mentioned much because more often than not, there were no large battles at all on these fronts until the clones arrived. The PSF served another important role during the war as well. They were responsible for local conscription. Without GAR conscripts as reinforcements, the clones likely would have been wiped out early into the war. The Republic Judicial Department was another essential component of the GAR, having served as the Republic's only real military force prior to the Separatist crisis. The judicial forces primarily consisted of a small set of ground forces, a fleet of lighter warships, and the Jedi Order, and they were tasked with maintaining order on a galactic scale. They were essentially called in for military maneuvers that the PSFs couldn't handle, and their red-painted ships were essentially synonymous to peace and security to much of the Republic. When the Clone Wars broke out, the judicial forces were merged into the new Republic military like with the PSFs, but they served a much different role. The judicial forces provided a much-needed command structure for the new military, providing the clones of the GAR and the Republic Navy with capable, experienced commanding officers. The Jedi were the most visible part of this, but a lot of the Republic Navy's most well-known figures, like Captains Terranald Screed and Jan Dodona, came out of the Judicial Department as well. There are plenty of other, smaller groups that contributed to the Republic war effort as well. A large part of Republic intelligence was composed of non-clones, as was the entirety of the Senate Guard, which ensured security for diplomats. Security and maintenance roles in the Jedi Temple and low-ranking Republic Navy positions were held by non-clone recruits. And, of course, Loyalist militias had large roles in many key battles. Of particular importance were holdovers of the Republic Navy, members of families that had long history with the Navy before the Rusan reformations, whose intricate knowledge of naval tradition helped bring order to the re-established Navy, which the Kaminoans had done a poor job of organizing. So, those were the non-clone components of the Republic military, and as per usual, I want to know your thoughts in the comment section below. Did you guys actually know about any of these, and would you like to see more about them in the future? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below. And just before you go, guys, if you are into history, as many Star Wars fans are, I actually have my own history channel sitting around about 8,000 subscribers. Now, recently, the videos on the channel have been sporadic at best. Sometimes I had monthly breaks in them, sometimes I had weekly breaks in them. But now, we finally got a system down pat where we're doing 3 videos a week on that channel, all about niche World War I, World War II, and Vietnam War content, and even other wars that we may cover in the future. So, if you are interested in history, make sure you check that out. And also, you may have noticed an increase in the quality of the mic system, and that is thanks to all my patrons. Their names are in the description below, and if you do want to help improve this channel consistently, then please do check out the Patreon, because this increase in quality is thanks to them. Anyways, guys, as always, thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video.